Goes back to Peter Stastny at the right point. Fires Stastny right on to the left side to Marois. Back to Stastny. Short-handed breakaway by Dave Poulin. He's gone right on in. Shoot! Score! I don't ever remember the Flyers scoring a short-handed goal, two men down in a playoff game.
Poulin in a perfectly positioned for that pass. Went in and beat Gosselin high on the glove side, and the Flyers are still two men short. What an effort by Dave Poulin.
Here's Ramsey going after it. Now Sakic. Gotta get it back. Arneil. He'll try to come up with it. He does. Lost it now. He sends it ahead to a rushing Housley. Housley's got a breakaway. Going right in and goal. Shoots. He scores! Housley with the Sabres down by two players, gets a short-handed goal, and the Sabres take a 3-0 lead.
Watch how he scores this goal with authority. What a beautiful goal. I mean, just to pull that puck into the forehand, the man is on top of him, and he still just fires it right up into the corner with so much authority.
Diafredi knocks it down, keeps it in, but Ricci has a break between the defensemen. Côté and Ricci go after it. Ricci now sends it in front. Beaupre's down, scores! Kärntner, the Caps have a two-man advantage, but the Flyers are on the board.
And there's their league-leading eighth goal, Jeff, short-handed. Diafredi circles away, and the guy that started it, Terry Kärntner, picks up a short-handed marker. The Flyers, man down, two man down in this situation. Doesn't happen too often in the National Hockey League.
Lindstrom, though, followed up to Fedorov. He gave it to Coffey. Forced to shoot it in with a two-man advantage. Barrett back and gets help to clear.
Here. A breakaway for Hull. He's two men short. He's in. Hull the shot. He scores. What a turn of events. Brad Hull, while the Blues are short-handed by two men, scores a short-handed goal with a nifty backhander. 2-1 Detroit.
The Red Wings were having trouble getting the puck over the line. As you pointed out, they had to shoot it in. Look at Hull on the top of your screen, in behind Paul Coffey. And the little tip out by Shanahan, Hull's alone, goes to the backhand, and just outside the outstretched leg of Mike Vernon, Brett Hull makes it a 2-1 hockey game with 35 seconds still left in the two penalties to St. Louis. Brodeur peers out at this faceoff that involves Kozlov and Madden. It's wheeled back off. Svejla tried to keep it out to center. Taken by Madden. Moving on in. Fire! Save! Rebound! Niedermeyer! Score!
Wow! John Madden, who's been the best, one of the best penalty killers all season in the National Hockey League, breaks away and shoots it low. And again, a smart shot by John Madden. He shoots it to the left side of Vernon. That means if Vernon does make the save, where's the puck going to come? It's going to come out to the center of the ice. That's what happens. And following up with great speed, Scott Niedermeyer, and he puts it under the stick of Mike Vernon.
Solani was given
a misconduct for Teemu Solani. Lindros drops it off for Fleury. Missed it. Here's a breakaway. Vinny Domfus breaking in. Domfus goes to the net, and he scores. A shorthanded goal on a 5-on-3.
Drop pass back to the point, and Fleury lost his footing. He just simply went down. Lindros drops it back. Fleury went to get it. He dropped, and Stewart, the defenseman, just stayed in behind, and Domfus, who's a... He's just a great goal scorer. He just went in and put it through the legs of Blackburn. And the kid, Blackburn, has seen something today, hasn't he?
He swept it wide. I said Jokinen had come on. Jokinen was waiting, but it was Nielsen who jumped on. Ferentz, Nielsen waits in the slot. Ferentz battles against Modano, who wins it, and now tips it ahead, and there's a foot race. Short-handed breakaway. 5-on-3, Modano scores. Oh, my! A 5-on-3 for Florida, and Modano converts on a 5-on-3 two-man short situation. The shorthanded goal bursts the bubble for Florida.
One of the best in the game in all areas of the ice. Mike Modano makes the Panthers pay, not showing any symptoms of weakness because of the so-called flu, as he scores both goals for the Dallas Stars.
Wasichek. checked by Sweeney. One hands it wide. Blue line, Francis can't keep it in. Ralston breaks. Brian Ralston, shorthanded, two men down. Ralston scores!
You can see why Brian Ralston was in the Olympics, because this is an all-world play right here. Another shorthanded goal to take back the lead in shorthanded goals. And he got Urbay to bite on that deke. Little fake shot there. Down goes Urbay and makes it look easy.
Janssen turns it over, at least temporarily, to Yakhmanev. Parrish couldn't get it deep. Now Hamerlik brings it in, and the Islanders can set up. A weak pass for Bates. He couldn't reach it under pressure from Skrastich, who moves to the Islander line. Shoots. He scores! A shorthanded goal by Carlos Skrastich with Nashville down two men.
Skrastich, the defenseman. Watch where he just takes off after Bates steals the puck from him, and then this wrist shot uses Kenny Janssen as a screen, but that's one that Chris Osgood should have stopped. And Chris Osgood has to stop that one.
You got to get the puck to the net quicker than that. You allow the triangle to set up when you're this slow.
Here's Nienema looking for Carter on the one-timer. Blake again breaks it up, and now Colorado breaks out 2-on-1. Blake with Eric Messier. Blake tees it up. Rebound, Eric Messier scores! Short-handed goal for Colorado, the Avalanche's first short-handed goal of the season.
Too predictable from the Edmonton Oilers, and a great hustle play by Rob Blake, who initially starts a play by chipping the puck into the neutral zone. You got to have an active stick, 5-on-3, last one on goal, poor rebound control, and what a job from the unheralded Eric Messier, driving into the net, sacrificing his body, and putting that thing to the back of the net.
A 3-on-5 goal, very rare in the National Hockey League.
3-2 advantage in favor of Carolina. A 5-on-3 for the Hurricanes, and can you believe this? Daniel Tungqvist with the slap shot on a 5-on-3 shorthanded marker, Atlanta winning 5-2.
Rangers got away with one cross check, didn't get away with the other, as Pody went for cross checking in 17 minutes. Giveaway, here's Tootin in shorthanded. He scores! Fedor Tootin's first NHL goal, a shorthanded goal, and it's 2-0 Rangers.
Two men down with the Rangers, not only a shorthanded goal, I mean, that's two gifts that the Panthers gave to the Rangers, but Tootin had the first shot taken away, and Luongo committed himself, came out. Watch this, Luongo's so far out now, he's down, and Tootin's able to put it up underneath the crossbar.
The guy he wanted to get it to was in the clear, Bob, but so many feet and sticks, it never got through. And it's a break, 2-on-1 for Philadelphia. Moving up is Richards, coming in with Hansen, he scores! Well, well, well. A big move, two of them broke away. Gets a shorthanded goal, and it's a 2-1 game, Flyers.
And Richards gets the goal on a gorgeous shot that seemed to handcuff Belfour. And Klee figures you can let the guy shoot from there and you'll be all right, but somehow he got it by on the glove side.
Looks taken by Spachuk. The other side, back to Spachuk again. Commonville tried to rifle it into the corner, maybe a little too cute there, and Cole strikes away, one man back. Cole getting in over the line. Cole going wide with a shot, the rebound, they score! Coming in late on the rebound was Commodore, and Commodore has made it a one-goal game with lots of time left, 1:15, and Carolina does that two men short.
I'll say, that's a rarity. Beautiful stick-handling maneuver, though, by Eric Cole on Yaroslav Spachek, and Commodore taps home the rebound.
15 seconds to go on the two-man. Recchi still in front of the goal as Sidney Crosby fires one right at the man who was standing in front of him. And now the puck is cleared off the wall by that man, Richard Park. A foot race with Gonchar. Park wins the race and scores! Oh, what a play by Richard Park as he scores a shorthanded goal in a 5-on-3.
Sidney Crosby had a shot blocked at the point by Richard Park, the ex-Penguin. And Park had enough presence of mind to see Crosby try to block that clearing attempt by Park. He went off the boards with it, got his feet going. Gonchar, he couldn't get back to the center of the ice quick enough. It was a good foot race, and Richard Park won it, and what a shot that was.
You saw Ben Eager serving the penalty. On boards, here's a steal, a chance. Mike Richards, down two men. He scores! Mike Richards, a goal with two men down, and it is 8-2.
to Philadelphia as their magic in Vancouver continues.
When Mike Richards came out of junior for the Kitchener Rangers, they said he was an outstanding penalty killer. Well, what a perfect example here. Nice little move, and then finds the five hole of Sanford.
Had a couple of words with Bill McCurry. McCurry gave the extra penalty.
Rangers have a two-man advantage and a steal. Richard Park goes in shorthanded and scores. The Islanders, two men shorthanded, get a shorthanded goal from Richard Park and lead for the third time in the game.
Yeah, Richard Park is an excellent penalty killer. You just don't see this too often. He wins the faceoff first. See, that hit Shanahan and bounced to the middle. And so the Rangers with five forwards on the ice, and that was a tough play for Shanahan to handle the puck as it hit him, directed towards the middle. Lundqvist only gets a piece of the shorthanded goal.
48 left on the 5-1-3. Dealt back in for the hold by Drury now. Creeps to the outside. Drury up last, and that knocked down in front. And laid back out and charging ahead with it on a breakaway is Richards. Score! Two men short. Second goal for the Flyers.
That shot gets blocked by Colbert, and then the quick movement for Richards, and so
great pass there by Brady Colbert. The speed, look what Mike Richards does. He doesn't stick handle, he pushes the puck, and that puck flutters off the stick of Richards. He doesn't get a lot on it all, and I think that Henrik Lundqvist is anticipating a harder shot. He's got to make that stop.
Boston gets a change. Johnson drops it back. Campbell steps forward. He's got a breakaway. 3-on-5. Campbell, he scores! A 3-on-5 shorty. Back to Montreal they go. Soundly beaten.
Oh, what a beautiful read by the Bruins penalty killers. It started with the Bergeron combination. McQuaid jumped into the play, and then it's Campbell who's been real good tonight, making the most of his ice time.
No, I don't think so.
Okay. So the Leafs, two men short, but Bozak's got a break. Tyler Bozak in, scores! 3-on-5, Bozak has a shorthanded goal, and the Leafs are within one.
Mike Richards of the Philadelphia Flyers usually does this to the Toronto Maple Leafs. Good on Tyler Bozak doing this to the New Jersey Devils. The Devils actually win the draw. It's not moved hard enough to the point. And that has Brian Ralston out to try. And Tyler Bozak taking it to his backhand from his forehand.
Now, Yager shot. Adams got in front of that shot and blocked it away.
He did.
The bouncing puck that gets past Kiemann. And now Matt Cook will be the first to it. Cook trying to cut in on it. Oh, he's hooked. He scores! A two-man down goal for Matt Cook.
Then Matt Cook catches Kiemann and flat-footed. And Brizgalov is going to be relieved by Bobrovsky. And they are booing him all the way to the runway.
The Leafs go on a 5-on-3 here. Gardner, he's in alone on a shorthanded breakaway. He lost control of the puck, and it still went in.
Faceoffs are so critical, especially when you're taking a defensive zone faceoff like Pekanic. He wins the draw and pushes forward and just turns on the jets coming through the middle of the ice surface, loses the handle on this one, and it still ends up going through the five hole.
Kreider near the front of the net. Meanwhile, San Luis again to the outside. Then Boyle, then San Luis. Trouble, and it's going to be a break for the Lightning. Johnson is moving on in. Shorthanded. Save. Rebound. Score! But doesn't count.
Well, Johnson has the opportunity. St. Louis at the last second dives. And Marty St. Louis goes crashing into those. From my vantage point, I thought the puck was across the line before the nets came off its holders.
I agree with you. I don't think the integrity of the scoring area was disturbed at all. I think that's going to be a special play for Tyler Johnson and the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Upon video review, the puck is clearly crossed the line and in the net prior to the net coming off. Therefore, we have a good goal.
Murphy lets the shot go off the stick of Ladd and high. Ladd to the far side. Chips it to the line, but not out, and now deflected. Here comes Buffalo. Shorthanded. Buffalo scores!
and Dustin Byfuglien makes no mistake as he goes over the blocker and finishes it perfectly.
We'll clarify the second penalty as soon as we get word. Taken by the Devils, and here comes Henrique. Into the Maple Leaf zone, Adam Henrique, save made, the rebound, they score! Brian Gibbons, a 3-on-5 goal for New Jersey.
Are you kidding me? 3-on-5, Adam Henrique doesn't care. He goes to the net, felt the Leafs were a little lackadaisical defensively, and he controls that puck, gets himself a good opportunity. One more look at it here. Henrique off to the races, Gardner with trouble. He recognizes it's a forward, Nylander 1-on-1. He swipes the puck to Anderson, but he bats it right to Brian Gibbons. He buries the shorthanded goal. Devils up 4-2.